the blood puddle and undertake it. A mockery, a competition, usually ending up with a pacemaker. Heart regulator, army major, blood clot, castration, musically spinning.
Coming up next, a UFC welterweight division matchup. Well, we probably trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts more than we should, but this fighter certainly fits the bill.
Oh, 110%. He can do everything inside the octagon. Where he is most comfortable is inside of that eight-sided structure where right. Most men are terrified of being. But for this gentleman, he only wants to be there. When you try to wrestle him, he's able to defend takedowns. If you dare stand and strike with him, he can knock you out. Got all the tools necessary to become a UFC champion.
His first martial art, mixed martial arts, yeah. And that's not always the case. He believes that he should have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. Well, you hear the pop from the crowd, DC, as Nate Diaz gets set to make this walk here tonight. You never know when it's going to be the last time we see this guy compete, but there's a lot to like when we see Nate Diaz in the air.
Nate Diaz is a savage, a guy that just epitomizes fighter. From the attitude, the walk, the music, everything tells you that when Nate Diaz shows up, you're getting ready to watch a fight. A fantastic striker and a great jiu-jitsu practitioner. Yeah. Nate Diaz is just a well-rounded fighter and one of the biggest stars in the UFC.
We've seen the Stockton slap before. I'll set the total.
It's just so disrespectful.
Over under 1.5.
So
I think he throws it tonight.
It's just so disrespectful, but it's so Nate Diaz.
All right, we'll see if he invokes the Stockton slap here tonight. But Nate Diaz is back, and hopefully in a big way for his supporters around the world. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight. Diaz is 16 years the elder. He is 1 inch taller. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. We go inside the octagon. Here's the veteran voice, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 15 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 166 pounds. Fighting out of Lisbon, Portugal, Reis. And now, here's his opponent. Fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 21 wins, 16 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California. He is an Ultimate Fighter season winner, Nate Diaz! And when the action begins, a referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here. Ready to go for round one. As many of you know, this young man won his last fight by knockout. No TKO, flush knockout for him the last time out. And now he is getting a shot against a truly elite fighter in this. Oh! All right, here we go. Early round one. Going to be very interesting to see how long this fight stays upright, given the fact that he is so good with his.
Whoa! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment.
Striking technique to land that shot and ultimately finish the fight here in the first. You've heard us say it before, but sometimes when you catch a guy cold before he's had a chance to get going in the fight, it can have a bigger effect. It certainly did here tonight. All right, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight, but don't ignore all the work he did with his hands. And give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine is going to stop for this contest at 1 minute, 22 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Hayes.
All right, so there he is, the man of the moment, celebrating one of the bigger knockout victories of his career. And gotta be nice sometimes with all the hard work that you guys put in when it goes down exactly the way you drew it up.
A lot of people talk about doing certain things. It's harder to deliver on those promises you make to the public. Tonight, he did exactly that. Congratulations.